Thank you.
Strength stage right now, getting ready to prepare here with Jon Bruney and Randy Couture behind the scenes. It's going to be a phenomenal day. We're really looking forward to it. It's going to be awesome.
I'd like to introduce our very special guest. You know him as a six-time UFC champion, UFC Hall of Famer, International Sports Hall of Famer, and one of the greatest martial artists of all time. Please welcome to the stage, Mr. Randy, the Natural Couture. Now, you volunteered for all of this stuff. So be ready for what's going to happen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to give it up for Coach Jon Bruney.
And so what we are going to do is we are going to put tools in your hands, techniques in your hands, so that you walk out of here with something practical that you can take home and apply to any training that you want. So if you're an MMA person here today, awesome. You're going to learn some low-tech ways to practice elevation training. You're going to learn to get multiple types of resistance. If you are a strong man, you're going to learn a lot of stuff today. If you're a powerlifter, bodybuilder, no matter who you are, you're going to learn something today. Now, what we're going to be talking about overall today is called Neuro Power. What we want to do is learn to tie the brain into the body so that you get more neuromuscular efficiency. Some of the strongest people in the world are not the biggest people in the world. They're people that have been able to overcome mental blocks. So what we want to do is basically we're going to learn today how to make the body smarter. All right? All of us do not get to choose our genetics, right? How many of you wish you could choose your genetics, right? If we could, we'd all be like, I want to be like Arnold. I want to be like the natural, you know. If we could choose, we would. What we're going to do is we're going to show you techniques that will allow you to bypass your genetic potential. Then we're also going to teach you some simple principles that you can apply in anything that you do. And then lastly, we're going to have some demonstrations of how all this comes together. Now, first of all, I want to talk about the grind and go principle. How many understand what that is? How many know what a grinding lift is? By show of hands. Okay, so we're gonna be talking about that in a moment. All sports, all athletic activity requires you to have several different types of strength and power. And we call this the grind and go principle. For instance, if you are a football player, if you're an offensive lineman, you need to get down on the line, you need to explode into somebody, and then all of a sudden you're grinding, you're pushing, and then at the drop of a hat, at the snap of a finger, you need to be sprinting downfield. We want to teach that kind of strength. If you're a fighter, you may be tied up, and all of a sudden you need to throw. That's the grind and go principle. The first time that this became a big reality to me was when I set my first world record with my friend John Brookfield and Steve Jett. We pulled a 38,000 pound semi truck with a trailer on the back with a full band and about 30 people. We pulled it for a world record distance of a mile. Now let me tell you, that's not just a feat of strength, but it's endurance and mental power. So if you've ever done any kind of truck pulling, what you've got to do at the beginning is there's that grind to get it to start. In fact, when you get hooked up to that harness, when you have those ropes in front of you, it feels like that thing is never, ever going to move. So it's an all-out grind. I mean, you are, you know, just all of your guts, everything is into that. And then the second that it gets rolling, you have to go. You have to be able to explode, because if you don't, the truck is going to stop and you're going to start all over again. So one of the best ways I can describe that, Drew, if you have me this frying pan here, there are some stunts we wanted to do today that the convention center wouldn't let us do because they were dangerous. At the end, actually, Randy was going to drop a bowling ball off a ladder on my stomach. But have no fear, Randy is still going to punish me at the end. So if you're into that type of thing, you need to stick around. Yeah, I heard a few Ric Flairs out there.
Woo!
Yeah, if you want to see that. So I'm going to demonstrate the grind and go principle here in a second. I'm going to have the mic handed over here to one of these guys. And what I'm going to do is you're going to see when you start to roll a frying pan, in the beginning, it's a grind. It's very hard. It takes some energy to get going. And then all of a sudden, you've got to explode and go, because as the metal gets hot, you got to keep it going until it's totally rolled up. So here's a demonstration of the grind and go principle. Thank you to all three of you who clapped for that. Front row, yes. That's awesome. But that's the grind and go principle. You start out slow, you grind until it happens. Now, also the other thing we're going to be talking about today is impact. The type of training that we're going to be working with today allows you to understand the two sides of impact. Now, when we think about impact, we usually think of martial arts or combat sports, but it applies in other areas of life too. There's two sides of impact. The first side is simply this. All of us need to be able to absorb impact. Some way, shape, or form, you need to be able to do it. But the second side of it is you need to be able to create impact. And what happens is we usually only have two types of athletes. Those who can create, you know, impact that can be explosive, or those who can take a lot of punishment. What we want to do is create a system where you receive both types of that training. And how we did it is there's a book I've written called Neuro-Mass. What we want to really talk about is the neuro set, how we tie the brain into the body to get extraordinary results. And we do it by combining three types of training. And if you do this, you will always be able to grind and go. You will always be able to absorb impact and create impact. So let's talk about what it is. Three types of training. The first one is grinds. What we want to do in every workout, we want to bring a grinding exercise. And if you don't know what that is, a grind can be done with your body weight, it can be done with kettlebells, it can be done with large amounts of weights. But a grind is a very slow, controlled, compound movement. So if I was to throw out what is a grind, I would probably hear back, what's the king of exercises? The deadlift or the squat. You know, there's people in both camps. But one of those two exercises would be a great example of a grind. Another example would be the overhead log press, heavy dumbbell press, heavy bench press. So what we want to do is start out in your training. We're going to put this into a Neuro set. We're going to move from a grinding exercise into something that is dynamic power. Now, what is a dynamic power drill? Well, a good example of that would be box jumps, jumping up, having your knees hit your chest, explosive lunges, any type of explosive movement, and we're going to do that for about 30 to 60 seconds. Now, the last ingredient to all this is one of the things that I think is the number one missing type of exercise in workout programs today, and that is isometrics. So we're moving from a grind to a what? Dynamic power drill into an isometric. Now, an isometric is very easily explained. In fact, I love, I think it was Brett Jones who said this. What is the heaviest weight you can lift is the one that you can't, okay? So an isometric is basically moving against immovable force. In other words, you're walking up to a tree and trying to knock that thing down for 10 or 12 seconds. You're resisting against chains or pushing against a brick wall. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to give an example of a sample of this, what this might look like in your training. Again, multiple forms of resistance make a smarter body. I'm going to have Caleb come out here. He's just going to demonstrate what a quick Neuro set would look like. All right, we're just going to do some body weight. Again, this is the great thing. If you lift weights, this is great. If you only do progressive calisthenics, this is awesome. No matter what your training is, you can make this happen. So if we were doing just a body weight Neuro set for legs, all right, we would start out with just some body weight squats, but slow and controlled. Go ahead and grab around here. Just do some slow, 8 to 10. And again, if we wanted to add resistance, I could put my big old body weight on them and get more. But again, 8 to 10, slow and controlled. Very good. Butt to the ground. There you go. And then immediately after that, he would switch to explosive lunges or scissors. So we'll do this for like 20, 30 seconds. Yep. Just exploding the scissors. I mean, it's very simple. And he would do that for 20 to 30 seconds. And then we would finish off with the isometric, which would be like the towel deadlift. Go ahead and grab the towel. He'd put that between his legs, or you could do a wall sit. There's hundreds of different isometrics, which we're going to talk about today. And then he would just pull for 10 to 12 seconds. You see every muscle is getting worked, the legs all the way up through the thing. Okay, that's good. So that's just a sample. Now, you would do a whole workout like that. So if you're lifting weights, you'd probably start out with the back squat, moving into some box jumps, finishing off with a wall squat or an extremely heavy leg press where you're locked out. Are you understanding the concept? It starts with grinds, dynamic power drills, and then it moves into isometrics. Now, what we want to do is continually challenge the body. Once you get this into your system and your body becomes trained, it becomes smarter, you need to keep throwing other challenges at it. I use it like this. We're going to give you some tools today that will be great examples, but I can tell you this, the best tool with the wrong knowledge will get you anywhere. It won't get you anywhere. You have to be trained. It's the difference of how many musicians here? All right, at the Arnold, we got two, all right? It's the difference between having a voice when you go on and you sing, La Sola Mia. There's no training there, but the potential is there, the tool is there. Once it's trained, you can come out and say, La Sola Mia. Do you see the difference? One is training, the other is not, but the tool was always there. So I know some of you are tied into kettlebells, some of you are tied into barbells. The tool isn't the most important thing, it's understanding how to use the tool. So one of the things that we have done, we have the Neuro grips out here. One of the things we have done is we tried to take the granddaddy of all exercises. I guarantee I see 100% of the hands raised here. How many of you have ever done a push-up? All right. What happens after you do push-ups after a while is the body gets very smart, and maybe even if you can only start off doing 10 to 20 at the beginning, all of a sudden you're ripping off 50, 100, 150, 200 in a workout. So what you want to do is always be adding things to make the body smarter to throw another challenge its way, correct? So what we did is these are called neuro grips. Now, if we were to take a study of the brain, we're going to look at your brain. A massive amount of your brain is dedicated to your hands. So if we were to show a big picture of what you really should look like according to the brain, your hands would be massive. I mean, you'd be a knuckle dragger, okay? So if we take any exercise and we add a grip component to it, all of a sudden the brain gets tied in and has to function. One of the worst things I ever see by athletes is that they go through their training mindlessly. That's why in my personal training, we always like to have a little bit of element of danger. Just that if you're not paying attention, you can get hurt, you know what I'm saying? So what we want to do is we're going to have these neuro grips here, and we're going to have Randy demonstrate them for us. If you want to come on down here. Well, give it up for Randy. You got to give it up for him if you want to see him do something crazy at the end. He's going to bust me up. So, well, come on down here, and I want you to tell me, just do a couple reps. First, we'll even get in the plank position. Yeah, you got it right. I mean, this guy's a hardened athlete, all right? Now, just give me 3 or 4 reps. I want you to notice how Randy, how the body trembles. Look at his hands, his wrists. Everything's engaged right there. The core, his back, his glutes, all the prime movers are happening. Very good. Give it up for Randy. Now let me ask you, tell me about like some of the activation there, how you're feeling.
Yeah, it's definitely a stabilization issue, which I think works a lot of other ones. Normally in the push-up, it doesn't really work, or half the work, to engage. So it definitely makes a difference.
Absolutely. And would you recommend this type of training for most athletes where they have to engage their core? Some of the inside of MMA or boxing or any combat sport, how much of the punching power comes from the shoulder versus how much comes from the hips and core?
I think all of the power comes from all the way from your big toe through your center, through your core, and out to the end of that fist.
Absolutely. So anything that we can do that will increase core strength is going to make us better. Thanks, Randy. I'll call you back up in a minute when you get to destroy me. Looking forward to that. So one of the things we want to do to work on core and how we can amp this up is after you get proficient at neuro grip push-ups, we have all different kind of positions that you can go in and do leverage. It's a great way to increase core strength. But one of the things I like to do is teach the X factor. How many have ever heard about training the X and how important that is in your body? The cross system that is built within us? How many have ever heard of cross crawls? Or when you do, okay, so let me explain that. When we do any kind of crossing thing in our body, that increases our mental stamina. It also increases our mental smartness as far as our body is concerned, because you were born to crawl, to walk. It's this whole pattern of when one side of the body moves, when my right leg moves, my opposite arm is supposed to move. It's called training the X. So one of the ways that we can do that and just radically challenge somebody is by putting bands on. Everybody has seen these bands before. How many people have had these bands? All kinds of brands. These ones happen to be rope because we're on the rope stage, which is awesome. Great privilege. We're going to show you a little technique here that even just standing is killer. All right? So I'm going to have Caleb come here. He's going to place one over one shoulder. So the idea, again, you gotta go opposite. We're gonna build an X here. All right, then he's gonna reach down and put one through each foot. Again, this is a workshop. Come learn how to do work, get an upgrade. It's not easy just getting into this, trust me. This will challenge your brain right here. How do I get into the best? Man, it's good. Let's straighten this out in the back. Now he's gonna tell you just to stand up. This is ridiculous. How much of your core is activated just standing? How much?
All of it.
It's killer. It's pushing him down, and again, he's got this resistance all the way. Now, if you are a fighter, if you're a striker, this is great. If you want to be a great bench presser or dumbbell presser, this is great. Why is this great for striking? Is notice the power. I've got resistance here in my hip driving through. So kind of give some punches there. And it's funny. I mean, I've had guys that are very well conditioned. I mean, this guy lifts weights with me all the time and effortlessly benches up over 400 pounds. I mean, he's a beast. And tell me, how much resistance is that? It's a lot of resistance just in the punching, and there's nothing attached to the arm. So now if we were to take this up and dial it up another notch, let's have him do a push-up here. Now, before you even do it, just getting into this plank position, people, is ridiculous. You have to try it to understand how difficult it is. Now just give me a push-up. Every part of the body is starting to tremble, starting to shake, starting to quake a little bit. All right. Very good. Let's give it up for Caleb. All right. So, one of the other things we want to talk about today is once you start getting these things in motion, what are ways that we can amp up the training mentally and physically? Because again, it's about making your body smarter. One of the ways that we can do that is strategic stops. So I'm gonna have Caleb come back over here. He's gonna love me after a while. I'm gonna have you get in the push-up plank position if you would. We're not gonna go to the bricks yet. We'll save that. We call these strategic stops. So when you're doing your grinds, you can do strategic stops to increase the intensity. So come down halfway and just hold it. And now when he has to hold, there's isometric, the core is getting activated. You were doing this with squats. You put 500 pounds on your back and you pause, rest pause in the middle, come all the way down to the bottom, pause, and up. Okay, come down to your knees for a second to give some break for just a second. You see how strategic stops can be a tremendous intensifier. This system, you never have to stop growing. You have challenges that can happen over and over and over. So now what I want to do is show how we can build the explosivity into that. We can make it more explosive by taking a grind and putting a strategic stop and making it more explosive. So go ahead and get down in that position halfway. Then I can just resist against him. He's feeling that pressure. And when I let go, I'm going to let him explode. He'll probably get airborne. 3, 2, 1, explode. Okay, you see how that works? Strategic stops and explosion, you just get somebody to partner, whether you're doing squats, deadlifts, or all these other type of things. Now, if we really want to dial up the intensity, one of my favorite things, and this is the source of unbelievable work capacity, this is used for creativity and problem solving. Again, much of your brain is dedicated to your hands. So what we can do is we can actually use the hands in our workout through different tactile sensations and problem solving to create a workout that will absolutely destroy you. Let's bring out the blocks for a second. It's amazing how toys can totally rock your world. You're gonna get rocked with the blocks, all right? So we're gonna take this pile of blocks and we're just gonna set it down beside him. I'm gonna have him do, and try this at home. You'll be amazed at how much work capacity this builds. What I want you to do is you get in that plank position. I want you to take one block, put it to the middle, take the other hand. Now what he's gonna do is he's just gonna start stacking. He's gonna build something on the other side. Every part of the core, he's getting challenged from every different area just by having to move some blocks. And the final one. And I'm telling you, try it at home, you'll get gassed, and you can actually put the bands on and make it even more difficult. So that would be considered a moving plank. Another one is that we want to move laterally. We talk about the degrees of movement. So many of us spend so much time going forward that we don't realize that we were meant to move laterally also. And lateral movement with the legs is pretty easy because you can take some weights, heavy kettlebells or something, you can do lateral shuffles back and forth. How do we work the upper body laterally? How do we tie in a lot of the things we've been talking about into that? Well, we simply use some bricks. I'm gonna have Caleb start on one side. Okay, And he's going to go and pop up. He's going to walk over the other side, down. Walk. He's gonna punch me afterwards because he's getting put through the paces. And then as you get better, you get more explosive. And pretty soon, you can just begin to pop up there. Now, tell me what sport this would be good for. Every sport, all right? Very good. Now we're gonna get into some conditioning aspects. What are some ways we can challenge the body to be smarter through conditioning? Well, one of the hottest things today that's out there is elevation training. How many have heard of elevation training? Almost all of you. How many of you out there have an elevation mask or some kind of breathing device, okay? The cool thing about those are is they restrict the amount of air coming in. What people don't actually understand about elevation training is elevation training is about having less oxygen in the air itself, not the amount of air that you are sucking in. So a lot of people cannot afford to go and have like expensive time sitting in a chamber. They can't have all these times to go up in the mountains for a couple months and train. I can give you a way, and again, I'm not a doctor, so if you try this at your own risk. I can give you a way that will give you permanent results. You can raise red blood cell count numbers, all these different things. You can elevate EPO, all these different types of things in your body by simply doing this. I'm gonna give you the most expensive elevation training device on the market. It's gonna cost you pennies. How many of you have ever heard of Bohr's Law? Okay? Carbon dioxide, it's the more carbon dioxide, we're talking about carbon dioxide enrichment, that actually oxygenates the body. The higher your tolerance is to carbon dioxide, the more oxygen your body takes and loads. So this simple technique, is you would just take this paper bag, you'd put it over your mouth, you'd set your timer. It's very important you set your timer. You set it for 30 seconds and you'd simply do this. And you do that for 30 seconds, okay? And then you stop. Now what you wanna do is do that for every hour, on the hour, for about a month, and the changes will be permanent. You'll have bigger ways of being able to transport the red blood cells, all kinds of things will happen. That's a low-tech way to do that. So that's one side of conditioning. We call that the carbon dioxide paradox or carbon dioxide enrichment. The other side is simply doing this, is making sure that your cardio or what you're doing for your heart rate or your conditioning actually is transferable over to not only your metabolism, not getting a metabolic rise, but also that transfers to your training. So one of the simplest tools you can do is to get a beach towel. I'm gonna have both my helpers here do this. So we got a simple beach towel. Now, this is level one. I've actually created a product called the Neuro-Burner, but that's an advanced product. It's a parachute, okay? So what a lot of this comes out of is how many of you had played with the parachute in gym class in elementary school? That's where this comes out of, except the idea is not to go slow up in the air and down. The idea is to build velocity. Velocity, or being able to sustain it, is one of the biggest missing pieces in all of training today. So we want to talk about that for a moment. So what I'm gonna have these guys do is first get in an isometric stance. Just get on a squat so you're locked down, okay? And now we're going to take this and you're gonna just shake it up and down as fast as you can. A little harder, a little faster, it's velocity. Now if they were using a parachute or harder material, after a while, you would not believe how gassed you get. In fact, afterwards, if you wanna try this, you try and rip it out of the other guy's hands, it gets very, very intense. So then I would say stop. Now here's the other thing. What we wanna do into all of our exercise is add what we call active recovery. So you're not just sitting there just doing nothing, but you want to be doing something that's gonna help the body recover faster. So if we were doing these sessions of 45 seconds to 60 seconds, in between I would have them do the first exercise, which is the simple row. So bring it up. One guy's gonna row in, one guy's gonna row out. Just light resistance, let it row back and forward. They would do this for active recovery for about 30 seconds in between the rounds, and then they would hit it again. So go ahead and hit it again. Ready to go? Okay, then they would stop for the sake of time, instead of stop. Then the next exercise we'd have to do for active recovery is to go turn around and do the tricep extension. Okay, so extend, forward, let them extend, extend, bring your elbows tight together. In front of a crowd, okay, very good. So does that make sense? Okay, so now how can we make the body smarter? Well, we've already started out by doing something that is an isometric movement tied into a dynamic movement. I'm gonna call these guys back out here again. Now what we wanna do is do opposing, step out a little further just because you don't step on anything. Yeah, that's good. Now what I wanna do is opposing dynamic movements. Now where this comes out of, how many have ever done this whole experiment of rubbing your belly and patting your head at the same time? Why is that hard the first time you try it? You have opposing dynamic movements. And so what we want to do then is do things that are going to be in the same training mode. So what I'm going to have these guys do is they're going to be going up and down with the towel. And again, for demonstration, they're not trying to kill each other. I hope when you try this one, you want to kill the person across. You want to destroy them. Now step this way a little bit because we're going to need to, there you go, really start to go. Now they're going to start doing explosive lunges. Go ahead and hit it. And it looks funny. Your brain is going off like fireworks saying, what in the world am I doing? And then we can take it to another level. Big one, stop. This time we're going to have you do that. We're going to have you drop into a squat. But when I say explode, you're going to get airborne and then drop another squat while you're doing this, okay? So go ahead and start rocking it again. Okay, now slowly squat down. We're starting to mess it. Explode up. And it messes your brain. This is the first time Adam's ever done this. Caleb's been doing this training with me for a long time. What does that feel like in your brain? Does it feel like you're jacked up?
Yeah.
And you're like, because what's happening is your brain is to process these things. But as you do it, again, creativity, problem, that's good. Creativity and problem solving is a big thing, especially for those of you who are in the mixed martial arts. It's continually solving problems time and time again. So we're going to continue on here. We've got a couple more things that we're going to show you. One of the things that we can also do in your training is how many of you have done any type of sensory deprivation? Again, these are low-tech ways to become incredible, to have super strength, endurance. One of the biggest ways we always tell people to do is to buy that 99-cent eye mask. You slip that over your eyes, and maybe you can do true shadow boxing, so you're boxing in the dark against an opponent you can't see. We also say, okay, with a partner's help, okay, you might do kettlebell swings, some of these movements where you're gonna drop that down and begin to move. But when you do that, all of the other senses are heightened. So what I challenge people to do is to do something like that, to go and say, I'm gonna do some blindfold. Other tastes, different sensory things in the gym, all those things will add to it. Now one of the most important things is getting warmed up for the workout. So many people come to the workout and their brain is not ready to fire. In other words, it's not just the pre-workout that you drink, it's charging up your neural system, your nervous system, getting ready to do work. One of the ways that we like to do that is, first of all, by trying to externally stimulate your motor cortex. Now, a lot of people do this through electricity and different aspects, but your motor cortex, if you just study the brain, runs right on the top of your ear, just like this. It's a band that goes over there. By simply getting and massaging deeply into the motor cortex before you go into the gym, you're gonna find that it stimulates that area. It wakes you up a little bit. The second thing we teach is the neurostump. Your feet are full of nerve endings. Just ask somebody who's been working here all week long. They will tell you there's a lot of nerve endings in your feet. You know what I'm saying? All right? So one of the things you can instantly do to increase your squat or your deadlift, I have people do this all the time, right before they're gonna squat heavy numbers, is simply do something called the neuro stomp. It's a nervous system stomp. Just by stomping down as hard as you can, that is firing up the body and prepping it to be able to handle heavy weights. And so that's an incredible, incredible thing that you wanna do. Another thing is simply this, learning to count out loud. All right, so before you go into the gym, You say, I'm going to count to 150 out loud. That stimulates the prefrontal cortex. All these different aspects are meant to fire up the nervous system to get you ready to perform at your best. So we're going to show one more exercise, and then we're going to have Randy in a moment come and breathe. 5 minutes? Okay, perfect. Actually, we're just going to end with this. If you have any questions, let me show you the book real quick. I'm going to have Randy Cox. We're down to our last 5 minutes. If you want to pick up this, I've got 2 copies left here. If you're interested in this, see me afterwards. You can also order on Amazon, but it's going to explain the whole system here, from doing sledgehammer push-ups to the hummingbird, all kinds of exercises you can do at home with or without equipment. But before we do that, we want to really, you might want to get your cameras ready because you might see somebody die on stage. I don't know. Before we close, we want to show what it means to be able to absorb impact. Now, the original idea we had, the Columbus Convention Center shut it down, but they aren't going to shut down this one. I'm going to lay down here, and they're going to place these blocks on my stomach, and then Randy, the natural. So you get fired up when you hear that, don't you? Couture is going to smash these off my stomach, hopefully not trying to kill me. We can remove one, but only need 3. But give Randy a warm welcome, and let's get Randy to break some ribs! All right, hold on here. Just in case anything goes wrong, it's been a pleasure to be with you. Really enjoyed it today. Thank you, Rogue, and all the great sponsors here. But we're going to get set. This is also going to be a trust factor. Because what we're going to do in a second, I'm going to have Caleb, first of all, place these bricks on my stomach. No space, just hold on to me a second. And then before Randy does that, I'm going to put this over my eyes. I have to put my total trust in Randy, because what happens is, if you see the hammer coming, you might flinch. If I flinch and I don't tighten up my core, there's going to be some serious damage. So I have to put my trust in Randy, and also hope that he doesn't make me the soprano in the choir. Right? You know what I'm saying? All right? So I'm going to get set here. Give it up for Randy, the natural Couture. And I turn it over to the main man. I tell you what, this guy is a legend everywhere. I turn it back over to Fairfax Hackley. Give it up for Fairfax.
How was that for entertainment, folks? Wow. The only thing I'm angry about is the fact that that was my aunt's frying pan. Okay? And I loaned that to you. And now she's going to be really, 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 really angry. Okay? But I would be impressed tonight. I'm going to take that back to my room, and I'm going to try to put it back together. Okay? That's not going to happen. Neuro-Mass or whatever. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up again for Coach Jon Bruney, his crew, and Randy, the natural.
Thank you.
Awesome. Can I take that frying pan with you?